Hi, my name is Dmytro Mrzęski. I'm the creator and an author of Decoded Frontend YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can use the NgRx createFeature function in order to reduce the amount of the boilerplate in your codebase. So continue watching and let's get started. Before we start coding, let's very quickly recap what is considered to be a feature in NgRx terminology. First of all, the NgRx feature, it is a dedicated state slice in the global NgRx store object, which has some dedicated key. In my case, it is a scientist feature key. Then every feature has a dedicated reducer. And reducer, it is simple function that is responsible for transition from one feature state to another one when some corresponding NgRx event is happening. And those two building blocks you register using provide state helper function if you use standalone API, or if you use ng modules, then you utilize the store module and the dedicated for feature method in order to register the feature. And to make the NgRx feature complete, we have to have a dedicated selectors. Those are functions that allow us to read the state of this feature. And once we have these three building blocks, we can go then in some component and use those selectors in order to read the state of the feature and select it from the global store. And as a result, I have the following simple application that can handle the loading state. Then it has a list of scientists and I can select one and see the detailed information about some certain scientist. But let's get back to the source code and namely to our NgRx feature selectors. And here I would like to highlight one disadvantage of the current implementation. And namely, I would like to highlight that I have to create a corresponding selector that allows me to read the state of my feature. And because my feature state consists of three properties, it means that for every of this property, I have to create a corresponding selector and I have to do it manually. And I have to do this similar work for every NgRx feature in my application. And we might have a lot of them. And this is where the createFeature function shines and helps us to reduce amount of the boilerplate in our application. So let's try to refactor our code and apply the createFeature function to see it in action. So let's jump to the scientist reducer. And somewhere here below, I'm going to create a new constant that has name scientist feature, and the value of it will be the result of the createFeature function, like that. So what takes this function as an argument? It takes a simple object that has to have at least two keys. The first one is a name, and this is nothing else as a feature key string, and it will be used in order to create the corresponding feature store slides in the global store object. And the second required property, it is a reducer that is related to this feature. In my case, this is this reducer. And by the way, I can shorten this notation just like that. And this is the minimum setup you have to perform. So now you can grab this constant and then go to app config. And in place of these two guys, you can use our feature we just created, just like that. And provide state function is smart enough to recognize that this time we provide the NgRx feature, so it will properly resolve the feature key and feature reducer. And to make sure that our application still works, we can go to the browser and you can see that everything works fine. But where the benefit, you might ask? And the benefit is that the createFeature function also generates a group of selectors that allow you to read every property in your feature state. So basically, things we were doing right here, all these four functions were generated for us automatically by the createFeature function. And because the generation of selectors happens at runtime, that's why there is one small restriction you have to know. And namely, you are not allowed to use optional fields in your feature state. In this case, you will get a compilation error. So what if you have to have some kind of optional field? In this case, you have to use something like null or undefined, but the main thing is that the key has to be always present in the feature state. I hope it is pretty much clear so far, so let's move forward. All right, because the basic feature selectors will be generated automatically, it means that we can go and remove the selectors we created manually and use auto-generated ones instead. This is really cool, but what about custom selectors? Likewise, this one that I created in order to get the data for the selected scientist. Here, as you can see, I'm not just reading the state property like I do it right here, but instead I rely on two other selectors in order to properly resolve the data and return the result value as a value for this concrete selector. So how we can solve this problem? Well, here the first thing you have to understand is that auto-generated selectors like those ones, they are absolutely normal selectors that you can actually import right here and use them instead those two. This is the first solution. But also you can do the following thing. You can provide a third property for the createFeature config object, and here you can define the extra selectors like that. And it takes function that returns the following object. So what has to be inside? Inside, as a key, you define the name of the extra selector. In my case, I will use this name of the old one. So then right here, I have to create a corresponding selector using the createSelector function like this. And here inside, I can already generate my extra selector that depends on the auto-generated selectors. And auto-generated selectors are coming as an argument for the extra selectors function. So they will be right in this argument. Or you can actually destructure this object and pick only the selectors you actually need. So in my case, I need selected ID selector and also select scientist one. And now I can do pretty much the same thing I did in the manually created selectors. So I define those two auto-generated selectors right here, and then I can resolve already the final value for this extra selector that is depending on the values from those auto-generated ones. And now we are ready to go. So because all the selectors will be generated by the createFeature function, we don't need the selectors file anymore, so I can simply go and remove it. Great, and now we just have to adjust our scientist component, because currently we use selectors that were coming from the deleted file, and now we have to say that now it comes from the reducer, namely they come from the scientist feature constant. So let's import it here, and right there everywhere I have to replace it with the imported scientist feature constant. And if we save this change and go to the browser, you can see that my application remains working. I can select the scientist and everything is working exactly as I expect. The final touch in my refactoring is really optional, but what I'm going to do is to rename the scientist reducer TS file a little bit, because currently, as you can see, it contains not only the reducer, but it contains the whole feature. So the name of the file doesn't actually reflect the content of this file. So that's why I will rename the reducer and name it just a state. You can name as you want, it depends on your naming convention, but I'm going to name it as a state. And of course, I have to update all the imports in my application. And in addition to that, I can also remove this scientist feature key constant because I don't reuse it anymore. I use it only here, so I can replace it with just a simple string. And after that, I can remove completely this constant. But if for whatever reason in the future you would need to get a reference to the feature name, then you can simply do it from the object that create feature function returns. And here you can find a name and you can find also the reducer. So the object returned by this function becomes kind of source of truth for the NgRx feature. And because of that, you can also remove the export keyword from the reducer constant because again, it is available right here. So as you can see, using of createFeature function can significantly reduce the amount of boilerplate in your application, especially if you have a big application with complex states and a lot of selectors, because many of them that you had to create manually before, they will be generated automatically by the createFeature function. And in such a way, you will be focusing more on the feature delivery rather than doing the similar work over and over again. I hope this tutorial was useful, and if you would like to see more videos in collaboration with NgRx team, please let us know about that in the comments section under this video. And also let us know which exactly topics you would like to see covered. If you would like to see more videos about advanced Angular development in general, then please check out my YouTube channel. It is called Decoded Frontend. You can easily find it on YouTube. Otherwise, I wish you happy coding and see you in the next video.